So the Republicans decided to hold hearings about Obamacare. Why are they doing it? Well, you know why. They want to smear the website and go after it for the glitches and talk about the glitches endlessly and spread propaganda and waste everybody's time and stoke up fear. Well, apparently, Democratic Representative Frank Pallone Jr. Wasn't having it. His opinion on this issue is the same as mine. So listen to what he said when it was his turn to speak at the hearing.
HIPAA only applies when there's health information being provided. That's not in play here today. No health information is required in the application process. And why is that? Because pre-existing conditions don't matter. So once again, here we have my Republican colleagues trying to scare everybody.
Will the gentleman yield?
No, I will not yield to this monkey court or whatever this thing is.
This is not a monkey court.
Do whatever you want. I'm not yielding. I am trying to tell you that the problem here.
Protecting American citizens.
There are no pre-existing conditions.
It's a legitimate concern of this committee.
The pre-existing conditions don't matter. HIPAA doesn't apply. There's no health information in the process. You're asked about your address. Your date of birth, you're not asked health information. So why are we going down this path? Because you are trying to scare people so they don't apply, and so therefore the legislation gets delayed or the Affordable Care Act gets defunded or it's repealed. That's all it is, hoping people won't apply. Well, the fact of the matter is there are millions of people out there, over 20 million, that are going on this site, and they are going to apply, and they are ultimately going to be able to enroll. In fact, many of them already have enrolled. I think my Republican colleagues forget that a lot of people are enrolling through state exchanges rather than the federal exchange. And if it wasn't for the fact that many Republican governors, including my own from New Jersey, had agreed to set up state exchanges, then we wouldn't be putting so much burden on the federal system. But I just want to give you some examples. In New York and Washington, over 30,000 people have enrolled in coverage. In Oregon, over 50,000 people have enrolled. In California, over 100,000 have started application. In Kentucky, nearly 16,000 people have enrolled. So, you know, this website, this federal website, is not the only way that you apply. In fact, you can go to your community health center. You can go to the 1-800 number. You can go to, there are many ways for people to enroll. And all we talk about here is the website because you're trying to make a case that people should not enroll.
Yeah, that was one of the realest moments in the history of these silly committees. Look, a lot of people don't know this. They think like, oh my God, Congress, Washington, these guys, like they're wearing suits and ties. They have these committee hearings where they invite experts to speak. And oh my God, this is like high-minded stuff. I see a lot of papers on their desk. They must be doing something really high-minded. Actually, no, probably a majority of these committee hearings are total and utter bullshit. They're having a hearing about Obamacare. Why are you having a hearing about Obamacare? Dude, it passed in 2009. It's donezo. It's over. It's over. You're done, son. If you wanted to win the battle, Republicans, back then, maybe you should have won the election back then. Maybe you should have argued your point better. Maybe you should have got the American people to agree with you. And then people will say, oh my God, but Kyle, they're having a hearing about the glitches. How could you be against that? As if a hearing about the glitches is gonna fix the glitches. You wanna know how you fix the glitches? You fix the fucking glitches. It's called computer programmers. It's called actually sitting down and problem solving and working these things out. And by the way, I get it. It's not the politician's job to actually go in there and, you know, get the website to work. But make no mistake about it, these guys aren't helping. They're not trying to help.